not leaving the stage, just wanted to grab the microphone and add my thanks to Jane for everybody to coming today. It's great to see you all. The Brahms Horn Trio is one of those pieces that doesn't get performed terribly often, and partly because one has to cross the great divide between the string world and the wind world to assemble the forces, but it's a piece that every violinist falls in love with as soon as they try it. So we're most grateful to Melissa for joining us for this afternoon. I was going to ask Melissa to say a few words about the horn involved. Brahms wrote the piece in 1865. His mother had just died. If you think about where we were a couple weeks ago with Johannes Brahms' D minor concerto, the young Brahms we heard at that point. Now we've fast-forwarded to what some of the musicologists kind of call this piece, actually kind of the end of his second period. He's better known definitely than he was when he wrote the first concerto, but he's about to be catapulted to real fame by his German Requiem, actually, which he is just starting as he's working on this piece as well. And part of the impetus for this piece was that his mother died. He played the horn as a child, and so most people feel that that's one reason why the horn is in there. He specifies that he wanted the piece to be played by the natural horn, and I'm going to let Melissa tell you a little bit about that.
Thank you, and thank you so much for having me here. This is wonderful. So Brahms was actually very specific that he wanted this piece on wild horn or wild horn. It has a very dark sound, and it's actually a predecessor of a modern horn in that it has no vowels. It's a natural horn. So what that means to me as a horn player is that I have to be able to at least understand that this piece was written for something where the horn, what you would have done, the horn itself, the whole valve casing would have been gone. So all you would have had is the loops. And in order to put it in a different key, you would have pulled out the lead pipe and put in what's called a crook. And what that is a length of tubing that would lower it. Because as a horn player, to be able to play on the natural horn, we play up on what's called the clarino register. And I'm about to tip you off as to why horn players have such a hard time. Miss notes, and you should have mercy for your horn players, because we are going to aim for a target that's this big. If you watch my hand, I'm not going to move it, which means I'm doing everything with, well, my face.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.